the digital sector has been one key battlefield for Russia and its propaganda actions, the fake news phenomenon. Do you have or do you want to make some assessments on these challenges?
Definitely. We have to deal with disinformation. And we know that we already have E-Stratcom dealing with the disinformation cases. They identified already more than 4,800 different disinformation cases. But at the same time, of course, we know that pro-Kremlin media is quite well financed. Russia Today, Sputnik, they have 1.1 billion euros in a year. We know also that in St. Petersburg, in their troll factory, they have 1,000 full-time workers disseminating disinformation. So in Europe, we doubled the budget of Stratcom. Now it's 5 million euros. But our aim is not to use information as a weapon. Information is part of military doctrine in Russia, but in the European Union we will never use information as warfare. So to identify disinformation, debunking is important, but to share information between member states, it's also important, because it happened quite often so that at first they used some kind of disinformation in one country, then in another country, and so on. Then we have to negotiate also with the social media platforms. For all the member states separately to negotiate with those social media platforms, it's pretty complicated. I'm happy to say that social media platforms, they started to take disinformation campaigns much more seriously. They are using artificial intelligence, for example, Facebook, to identify disinformation campaigns. They took down millions of fake accounts, and I believe in those measures taken by social media platforms, because trust is one of those most important assets for social media platforms. If people, they will lose their trust, then they can easily switch on some kind of other sources of information. We remember what happened with those anonymous comments in our online media. 15 years ago in my country, for example, one concrete newspaper got 90% of all the traffic because of anonymous comments, and just 10% because of content, because of articles. People, they understood very soon that there is no debate. People, they are just shouting and stating their statements and not listening at all about others' arguments and so on. 5 years ago, the same newspaper got 90% of the traffic because of content, because of articles, and just 10% because of those anonymous comments. So it happened. And it can happen also with the really huge social media platforms. During the very short period of time, if people, they cannot trust anymore those sources of information, they can easily switch on some other sources of information. So it's in business interests of social media platforms to gain or to regain people's trust.